This is the church that Jean-Claude Duvalier attended as a child. Now it's the place where his family, friends and supporters came to pay their respects. It may not have had the pomp and circumstance of a state funeral, but it was well attended. The 63-year-old died of a heart attack just over a week ago. Close friends say he wanted to spend his last days in Haiti following 25 years of living in exile. Mourners included former military officers who still showed their loyalty to a man who ruled with an iron fist. To many here, Jean-Claude Duvalier was a leader who brought jobs and security.
Boost the economy, even though it was subcontracted work. But at least people had a place to go. They had, you know, hope that they would find a job.
Assassin Duvalier! Assassin Duvalier! Assassin!
But across town, protesters too wanted their voices to be heard. These Haitians gathered to remember those who were tortured and killed under the 15-year rule of a man better known to the world as Baby Doc.
It was a regime of blood, it was a regime of terror. It was a regime that repressed not only the citizens, right, but also all forms of expression and all forms of freedom of citizenship.
For many in Haiti, the death of Jean-Claude Duvalier represents the end of an era. Mourners here will tell you he brought the country prosperity. But for the victims of his 15-year regime, there's a sense that they were cheated. Just like his father, Jean-Claude Duvalier died a free man. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, Port-au-Prince, Haiti.